Hello, everyone, and welcome to our Pepsi Duck Pin Challenge. The Rhode Island Duck Pin Bowling Proprietors Association and the Connecticut Bowling Operators Association bring you our Duck Pin Challenge this afternoon. All the bowling action here in Cranston, Rhode Island, at the Legion Bowling Center. We'll have all of the action in a moment. My name is Norm Peters. This is Craig Self and Frank Ferry. We'll bring you all the colorful action. Stay with us.
Welcome to the Legion Bowl in Cranston, Rhode Island. Our Connecticut bowler today, Mary Ellen Vogt from Portland, Connecticut. Frank, who's going to be here from Rhode Island?
From Rhode Island, Joan Brochure from Coventry, Rhode Island.
Great. The winner of this first match is going to face our defending champion, Phyllis Saroy from Windsor, Connecticut. Phyllis shot 162 and 185, I believe, last time
out. Last two games.
Big games.
A tremendous performance. One of the most exciting matches I've ever seen.
That was with Debbie Concannon.
Right.
Ellie starts with an 8 drop.
She has a 4-7 up. Ellie's from the old school. She knows her job. Starts off with a spear.
I'm not sure, Frank, but I think Ellie bowls more games, sanctioned games, than anyone in duck pin bowling.
She loves the game.
Joan Brochure
of Coventry.
Here's another look at it. Joan Brochure of Coventry, Rhode Island, bowling here. Two marks to begin our challenge. Left one standing.
Jones currently carrying a 124 average. She has her mother, her mother-in-law, and her husband here today watching her.
I understand she has 3 grandchildren.
She picks up the spear.
Well, we've got all marks so far. Ellie started with a spare. Joan answered with a strike and a spare.
Going to
rip the middle.
You said Ellie bowls in 5 leagues?
7.
7 leagues. God bless her.
However many days there are in the week, that's how many leagues she's in.
Dedicated duck pin bowler.
Bowls over 1,000 games a year, sanctioned bowling.
She ends up in a 9 box. And 3 pocket leaves a split. Let's get the 5-4-7.
All right, she'll try and convert this for 10 with the third ball.
That ball was thrown just to clear a pin leaning up against the wall.
We'll see what Joan can do with her fill and the spare in the second frame.
She has another 9 drop.
Joan has a high game. of 202 and a high set of 489, a composite average of 124.
Those averages go up on the duck pin challenge, though.
Oh, she missed it to the left. She knew she missed it. She threw it. Joan is also a dedicated duck pin bowler. She belongs to the Pro Tour.
And she got it. Here's a look at the score as it stands. Joan Groshu, Mary Ellen Boat.
Oh, nice crossover.
Here's another look at that one. See how she did it.
One and two pocket. Beautiful hit.
A difficult spare with the 1-5 standing with the three others on the side.
She'd have to hit it just like that, only it didn't come off the wall.
Ball's not driving the five today, Frank.
No. She seems to be a little tight. But she's a veteran. She'll come back.
You only have 10 frames in this first match. And I say that because every game has 10 frames. But in the second match, the winner of this first one gets 20 frames at the defending champion to determine who's going to carry on the duck pin challenge.
Good time to tell you that the first place finisher picks up $300, the second place $150, and the third place $90.
She hit the 5-10 split. She hit the 5-pin. She'll try and convert this 10 pin for $10. Oh, just fell off.
52 through 5 frames for Ellie Vault.
So Joan's got a commanding lead right now. Oh, good hit, bad split. She's got the 4-10 up. She'll try and hit it on the left-hand side. Carry it over.
Joan is a spot bowler. She says the pins are too far away to concentrate on the use of boards.
She needs this for $10. Okay.
Through 5 frames, she has a 26 pin lead. Ellie's really going to have to get a little fire in her.
Ellie's going to need some strikes.
A little firepower. Ellie bowls, as I said, 7 leagues. She also bowls all the tournaments in Connecticut for sure. And then she also works as the manager for the 7-Eleven chain in Cromwell, Connecticut. She has no time.
There's another spare for Joan.
Joan had a spare in the fifth and the sixth.
Okay, Ellie looking for a mark.
Oh, right through
the middle again. Ellie is even with her frame, 60 in the sixth.
And she needs strikes.
Yeah, Joan is 88 plus.
She knows it.
Time for some bombs, Frank.
Yep, she's got to start bombing right here. Bombs.
Yep. Off to the side.
Yeah. She's got the 1, 3, 6, 5, and 7. Yes. Ellie's a little off today. She's just going by that head pin. $9.
Where's Joan from, Frank? Where's Joan from?
Coventry, Rhode Island. She bowls out of Town Hall Lanes in Johnston. And she wasn't coming to the roll-offs. I was talking to her one night. I said, "You're not going to the roll-offs?" And she says, "I don't know. I'm not bowling well." And here she is. I talked her into it, and she, here she is.
Top qualifier, huh?
Yep, she was the top qualifier. And she started hugging me and kissing me. She loves the game.
Bent for the frame.
Five. Another strike for Jones. Jones on.
Here's another look at the action.
1-3 pocket that time. Beautiful hit. That's a good ball by Ellie. She's got the 7-pin. Oh, she hung it to the right. Ellie's off today, as I said before.
But she's a little nervous?
Yeah, I think she's a little nervous.
That does it to people. Television sometimes unnerves
people.
Yeah,
you try to be relaxed, but it's, you know you're on.
It's a little different ball game. But she's a trooper.
Oh, look at this. 5-7-10. That's something you don't want to see when you throw a ball.
No, not at all. I think she'll shake off her nervousness. It'll come around.
She'll be back. You'll see a lot of her. She's a good bowler.
She's a trooper.
Oh, she's got an 8-box. It's not one of her better games.
There's her high single game of 202 for Joan Brochu. High three-game set of 489. She just found the ball she wanted, and away she goes.
Working on a strike. Oh, right through the middle.
You know, Frank, on Ellie's game, she has over 5,000 games rolled in the last 5 years of bowling with a 130 average.
So you can tell she's off today.
Off a little bit today.
5,000 games. God bless her. Oh, 8-box.
Now, whoever's going to bowl against Phyllis Saroy had better be on their game. We remember 3-4 weeks ago when Phyllis rolled at 185 to finish out, but she was tough.
What a match that was.
That looked like a good ball, but it
that
didn't
was a
ball.
Good pitch.
A 5-7 split.
Joan will be trying to hit this on the right-hand side. It's the 5-pin.
Well, she's in the 130s.
Oh, nice.
136 game, I believe.
And nice game, nice game.
Ellie's going to finish out, try to get a mark to finish, go over 100.
There's Ellie's. Oh, not a best, but that ball looked good going in. I'll tell you, she might have bowled a bad game today, but she'll be back with vengeance.
Okay, Joan finished with a 136.
Okay, we'll continue on with our Pepsi Duckpin Challenge here at the Legion Bowling Center in Cranston, Rhode Island, in a moment as Phyllis Saroy joins us.
Okay, let's clarify any confusion. In the first game, we had a score of 146 to 95. So Joan is going to face Phyllis Saroy now in the second match. This will be a 20-game roll-off, two full games, total pinfall.
Phyllis Saroy of Windsor, Connecticut, born in Fall River, Massachusetts.
She missed the head pin on the left. She got the 1-8, 2, and 6.
Right-handed bowler. Coming in on the left side.
Oh, nice shot. Nice try.
One pin shy of a spare.
She's always concentrating out there. She knows her job. She
deep
proved that the last time. Yes.
Paid off.
She picks her wood. Yeah. As repeated many times, that third ball is one of the most important balls you can throw.
Joan throws you.
1-3 pocket. Leaves the 5-8. Full concentration. Yes.
Starts with another mark.
Composite average of 124 for Joan Brochu. Won the first game with a score of 146. Over Mary Ellen Vogt, 95.
5-7 split. Good pitch. Joan be looking at the right side of that 5-pin. It over. Nice try. Nice try.
She knew what she had to do, but it didn't get over there far enough, huh?
She knew it.
Another try.
She was just picking a wood then.
27 pins through two frames. Phyllis started with a 10 frame. Recall, Frank, the triples that she threw her last outing.
Yep. Oh, okay. That was a good hit.
Winner of the Connecticut State Tournament doubles of 1985, Phyllis Saroy.
Phyllis ranked number 3 in the state of Connecticut in the last 4 seasons that she has bowled full seasons.
And she gets it.
It's funny because other bowlers would jump up into the 1 and 2 spot, but Phyllis just locked onto number 3 and stayed right there.
I'll tell you how dedicated she is. If she gets in with her bowling today, she'll be with her husband in the car rushing up to Wamisette to watch her husband bowl on the Pro Tour.
There it
nine
is.
9 job.
Good job.
Leaves a 7 pin. Fools her spare. That voice you hear in the back is your husband.
Rooting around, huh?
That's Ron. Boy, and right on it.
Then she'll be back again probably next week if she wins today.
She's a real good bowler. Oh, Joni answers with. Joni's trying to answer her spare with a spare. She leaves the 5 pin.
Continues this way, it's going to be a real close competition.
You got 2 good bowlers out there.
Yeah.
Yes. Right on the nose.
So far, evenly matched.
Well, we're 2 pins separating now. Joan looking to pick up a good fill here. And another mark.
Oh, right through the middle. 5.
That hurts.
Got the 3-4 and the 2-6-10. That's a good try. That's a good try.
That was excellent. If she could have caught a piece of the 3, it would have went over to the 2, possibly taken out the 4, and we'd have been all set.
Her Your ball seems to be working today. She's really... When her ball's moving, she's tough.
How many leagues does she bowl at Town Hall?
She bowls two leagues at Town Hall, and I think she bowls another one at Hot Side, I think it is.
So she's doing probably 400 games a year?
She goes to every pro tour there is and every tournament.
She leaves four. Four pins standing there. That's an easy split.
Yeah.
If you play it right.
Be in the pocket. You can hit it.
She did it. Perfect.
She is.
Exactly where it had to go.
Did she steer that in?
She made it look easy. It would be difficult for me, maybe easy for you and easy for her, Frank. But she sure made it look like, you know, there's nothing to it. She's tough.
She is tough. I'll tell you, if you want her title, you're going to have to take it because she's not going to give it to you.
Got a little break there.
It almost went down the middle and, you know, splitting them two ways. But
she
then
hit the 3-4-7 up.
She left them standing on the left.
Now, this spare here, you can hit it outside or you can hit it inside.
Mm-hmm.
We all try for the inside, but when we get it on the outside, we look just as big.
Too far.
She went over too far.
Yeah.
Whenever you make a spare in the alley, no matter how you make it, when they say nice shot, just accept it. It's not always the way you played it, but she ends up with a 10 box. She's got 73 in the fifth, 72 in the fifth. Joni goes through the middle again. Now, there's a tough one.
Three-step approach. She's playing
three,
those
four,
spots.
2-6. Trying to pick her wood here.
Frank, it's time to talk about some of the houses that sponsor our show. Of course, we've got the Connecticut Duck Pen establishments, but Amity Lanes, Arcade Bowling Lanes, Barnum Lanes, Cheshire Lanes, Highway Lanes, Holiday Lanes, Johnson's, Laurel Lanes, Lucky Strike, Metro Bowl, Perillo's, T-Bowl, Teller's, Villa Rose, and Torrington.
Right down the middle.
That's three straight times that Joni
and
went
I know that
middle.
You've got some lanes over in Rhode Island.
We sure. And before I tell you about the Rhode Island lanes, I'll wait till Joni shoots this box. I'll tell you a story about the lanes we're in right now.
Whoa.
What a try. What a try. She's got to pick her wood, though. She's got to pick her wood. She's had three straight through the middle jobs.
Oh, too far.
We're in one of the...
Okay, watch this side angle approach on this. Back to live action. Phyllis Soroy of Windsor, Connecticut.
Phyllis enjoying 13-pin lead at this point through five.
In the old days, the spare was hard to make, but with the rubbers on the side now, you can hit it like that. Oh,
oh.
She just missed it. You can glaze that, and the ball will take the 10 pin, believe it or not.
Right. We always used to leave the 10 pin.
Yep, and now the ball comes right out and takes it. And it's legit.
It's probably added 10 pins to everybody's score, right?
What I wanted to tell you about the lanes we're in.
The Legion Bowl?
Legion Bowl.
Mm-hmm.
Bruno D'Ambrosio is a Hall of Famer. He started.
Okay, excuse
lanes.
Me, winner, Hearthside Pro Tour of 1985. Now, go ahead.
He started with 6 lanes, then went to 14 lanes, then went to 20 lanes, then went to 30 lanes. Then when he passed away, his son took over and continued it. Him and his Bruno and his son Charlie are pioneers in duck pin bowling. They've given their life to duck pin bowling.
Repeat, we're in Cranston, Rhode Island.
I believe we're on the original 6, Frank.
We probably are.
Lanes 25 through 30. Beautiful.
Nice
conversion.
Spear. Nice spear.
Okay, watch this repeat action, front angle.
There she is. There she
there
is.
She goes. Our karate expert.
Joni's gonna
say what you will, it works at times.
Oh,
you know?
Yeah. She's got that body movement.
This Legion Bowling Center in Cranston, Rhode Island is where we are located. It's the Pepsi Duckpin Challenge being brought to you by the Rhode Island Duckpin Bowling Proprietors Association and the Connecticut Bowling Operators Association. This is Joan Brochu bowling. She's got her five pin.
Well, after all that, she missed it. Sometimes it's, you know, you lose your concentration.
It's tough, yeah. There it is.
Right, she came back with a 10 pin.
She was honest about it, though.
Oh, yeah.
I mean, she didn't, you know, try to say, hey, I got it all.
That's one thing about Joni. She's a good sport. She don't make excuses.
It was a good split screen shot.
She caught the break off the head pin.
Oh, that's the way it falls.
Now she's got a baby split.
With a spare here, Frank, she can potentially take over the lead in the seventh frame.
There's a look at our scoreboard right now.
Oh, right between them. That's close. That's coming close. When you can go between them like that, you're coming close. $9.
All right, Joan trails by four pins, 89 to 85 through seven.
Phyllis Saroy, who was patiently waiting. Phyllis of Windsor, Connecticut.
Good hit.
89 to 85 in the seventh frame.
She got the 4-7
Phyllis Saroy.
Full concentration.
Good ball.
Yes, right between them.
Right between
the
eyes.
That's the old saying, split them in two. That's the old saying. Girls are moving along at a good pace. Eight drop.
Made a few strikes, Frank. That'll liven up the
three,
pace.
Four. It sure will.
Deep concentration.
Split them in two.
He wanted that very badly.
Well, Joan is going to come up to bat.
All right, two marks for Phyllis. Puts a little pressure on Joan. Of course, we've got 20 frames to determine who's the champion. You want to leave that three pin if at all possible.
Yeah, it can be made. The other way, it's kind of,
this is where,
you know,
this is where a lot of bowlers are tempted to hit the pedal real quick.
And that's something you shouldn't do.
No, sir. You should let that pen at least drop its neck onto the deck. Right, Frank?
Right.
In the eighth frame, Phyllis Saroy with a 107. Joan Brochu up at the line.
Look at this.
Oh, that was awful close, Frank.
What a try.
She tried it right.
What a try. She gave it a little. She thought she might have had it.
Body English didn't work that time. Head on. Leaving two.
On eight frame, 93 through eight.
Good ball.
There
good ball.
Is.
And a strike.
Boy, you could see that coming. Let's
beautiful
take another
hit.
Look at that beautiful strike. Picture perfect.
1-3, as you please.
First strike for Joan, and it's only the second one of the entire day. See if she can double.
She's trying.
Oh, look at here.
Jeez. What a bad split. Maybe one of those ducks will knock something down.
7-10. That's a bowler's enemy.
She was hoping so, but it didn't work.
Well, don't forget, we still got a whole string to go. Should be 8.
Bad split.
Finishes with a 120. What a ball she's throwing.
Probably got the best reach of anyone around right now. She reaches all the way out there.
Notice when she puts her arm out there and the ball comes back, she's in shooting it. She's got a reverse on it. It's biting right into the pocket. Yes.
That concentration paid off that time.
I said, how do you feel today, Phyllis? She says, I'm going to win.
Phyllis has averaged 134 over the last 5 years.
Good positive attitude, Frank.
That's the way to think. That's
the way. Okay, Pepsi Duckpin Challenge continues
right,
here at the Legion Bowling Center
40,
in Cranston, Rhode Island
5.
In a moment. We'll be right back.
Okay, in our first match between Phyllis Saroy and Joan Brochu, the accurate score, 111-145. We've had a little trouble with the scoreboard. We hope it's been corrected, and we'll try and keep you posted. That means that Phyllis is coming into the second game with a 34-pin lead over Joan. Pretty substantial.
Oh, bad split, 7-10.
Our nemesis is back.
Is our scoreboard working now?
Yes, it seems to be. It's lit up.
I know we gave a few wrong scores. It was not our fault at the time. These new electronic devices sometimes fail.
These little gremlins creep in every once in a while, and you have to live with them. And,
we got a ladder out. We got the transistors fixed, and we're right back in business.
The microwave's back in operation.
Yeah, the microwave is. We got somebody in the microwave.
Whoops.
There we go. An eight to start.
Phyllis got a bad split then. She had the 7-10. Let's get an 8 box. Now Joni's got some work to do. And she'll be trying to do it. Oh, right. Oh, she had that split before in the first game.
I want to say that we would never try to give the viewers a bum steer or any kind of a problem we might have. We're always going to do our best to correct it and give you the correct score at all times, obviously.
A little buffalo in there, Norm.
Yeah.
There she goes again, right through the hole.
Too many great tries and not enough hits, Frank.
Yep, she's been close, but
right on the side of them. And
close is only good in horseshoes.
That's right.
That's the pitch, that's the pitch. Well, she gets two pins back anyways.
Well, from buffaloes to horseshoes, you know.
Joni's a hot sketch. She's always happy, always trying.
Oh.
She must have, 5 pin was the last pin to go down, thank God.
Good break.
Okay, 10-pin stands.
And Joni's gonna need this. Let's put some pressure on Phyllis. Oh, too much. She turned that ball too much.
To the right again, huh?
Yep. She's been missing, the ones that she's been missing has all been to the right today.
She won't throw it away though. Every pin counts.
Oh,
although she didn't get
bucks.
It.
Phyllis Saroy left a 7-10 last time.
Good ball.
It's barely.
3 pin.
2 pin.
That's what I said, a 2 pin.
I bet you thought he said a 3 pin.
I bet you thought I said a 2 pin.
I.
Oh. She missed that to the right, too.
By a whisker.
Picks up the 10 box. -18.
Still a 33-pin lead overall for Phyllis.
Oh, right, oh. Oh,
right down
1-5, the fates.
You'd never want to see that one. That is the worst enemy we have.
Beside the two in a corner.
7-10, yeah. Now, there's a girl that just threw two perfect balls. She gets 1-5 and she picks two more on the side.
Which one is she going to aim for, Frank?
She'd be on the left-hand side. Trying to come in like that. She just...
Six for the frame.
And even leave.
Yep, she's going to try to slide a three-pin into the other two. All right, Joni can make some ground there.
Still looking for our first mark in this second game.
Another shot right through the middle. Joni's had some bad luck today. She's had a few through the middle in this second match. Good try.
Good try. Need marks, though, to cut into that big lead from the first game.
And she takes it away.
She got 5 pins back from Phyllis's 34-pin lead from the first game. It's a 2-game total pinfall that determines who the champion is going to be to go on to next week's show.
Oh, she threw that one off. Oh, way through the middle again. She's getting a little disgusted.
Can't be upset. You can come right back with 4 or 5 strikes.
Oh, look at here.
I'll put this.
Nice try, Joni. Nice try.
It's got an easy delivery.
Very relaxed delivery.
She's letting it roll. She's letting it roll. Oh, not quite. When everybody turned the head away, the pin was still rolling. You never know. Okay, here comes Phyllis. In her mind, she's thinking, this is the time to put her away. Full concentration. Looks right at the pins.
Got a break there.
Yep.
Great break.
She's got 4-10.
In the fourth, right. In the fourth frame, Joan with a 39.
She has a 6-10 up.
Phyllis with a 24 in the third.
She picks it.
First mark of the second game.
Once she plants her feet, she's only looking directly at the pins. I don't think she ever takes her eye off. Look at here.
Oh, boy.
Leaves
good
the
break.
5-pin.
Oh.
The 10-pin was the last one to go down.
Phyllis's right arm went out to the right, and it took that second of the last pin standing there right down at the same time.
Frank, she's not going to miss this.
Not the way she's bowling.
She got it.
Last time she missed it on the right, and she was determined to put it out there this time.
She heard you say that, Frank.
John right. With a 9 drop. Leaves the 7 pin, the mother-in-law pin still standing.
She needs this one. She knows it.
We'll be back to all the action of our Pepsi Duckpin Challenge here at the Legion Bowling Center in Cranston, Rhode Island in a moment. Stay with us. Back to the action with Joan Brochu on the line. Winner of the LPGT in 1975.
She's sticking strike, 8 drop. Leaves the 5-8. Joni will take this one either way. Split him in two or she'll take it on the outside. She wants it. She knows this is her opportunity in this box to getting shorter. No.
Oh.
That's just tough luck. Hit the object pin.
Drive
and
it
don't
through.
Get your spear. Yeah, that's just tough luck. And she's had some tough luck today. So she takes a five pin lead in this game.
So she's trailing by 29 overall with two frames remaining.
So she's gonna.
What's her problem? I'm
she's
wondering.
Gonna need a bomb here.
Well, she really does need a double, Frank.
Yeah. But we gotta get the first one. That's the first one first.
Good ball. Whoa.
Well, you can hit them in Rhode Island, they don't fall over. Not in the Constitution state.
Well balanced.
Well, see, that's why we're that's why the Rhode Island bowlers are better bowlers. No, I'm only kidding.
They work harder, huh?
I'm only kidding. Look at that, that's two in a row. Two in a row she chopped off. She could have been right back in this match. No, sometimes, you won't believe it, sometimes it's got a lot to do with the weather.
Yes.
Believe me.
She took it.
So she ends up with a, oh no, she got one more box left. She's got 105 in the ninth.
Phyllis is 80 through seven. And Joan is 105 through nine.
Oh, she knows she can put it away here. She knows she can put it away. And Phyllis is an opportunist boy.
Let me correct what I just said. I believe Joan is 96 through 8. And Phyllis has a spare 90 plus through 8. Bring in some new transistors and diodes.
Jeez.
Oh,
bad split, bad split. 7-10.
Christmas is a long way off.
It's probably some crazy glue on the spot where that 10 pin stands.
Phyllis cracks a smile.
Well, Phyllis has the match in hand.
Yep, she's smiling. Ah, tough break.
Something's wrong. Okay. Good hit, Joey. She's another two pinner. She just chopped out two in a row. She chopped one out in the seventh box and one out in the eighth box. Now she's got another two pinner.
Oh, hey, where
right.
is the spare?
Nice ball.
No. All right, Joni said. If she got a triple in the last box.
And go to 146.
Right. She still couldn't do it.
Well, chances are she won.
Good ball.
And look at that. Oh, my God. Look at this. Look at this.
Hey. Let's take another look at that one on
look
slow
at this
motion.
Strike.
Watch
Frank,
this
you
strike
have more
action.
Control here than I thought.
What's this? Look at this. All the way over.
Somebody's on Joni's side. She's been
somebody
praying lately.
Somebody likes me. Now those two pinners she chopped out become very important.
Get them any way I can, she says.
Whoa!
Oh, is it going over?
Nope.
Nope. Nope. That's a solid seven. She only put her arms out and says.
If she can get this, she'd be at 136.
She's a good soul with a great sense of humor.
135.
135. Nice bowling. 135.
It's So Phyllis will return next week to meet our two challengers, one of them anyway, to see who will continue the Duck Pin Challenge Championship.
And remember, let's hope. Go to your participating duck pin proprietors.
Rhode Island and Connecticut.
They're all starting their summer leagues right now. You can join one. If you haven't bowled before, they got learners leagues. Senior citizens, they got a lot of leagues for the senior citizens. There's practically one every morning. So go see your participating proprietors.
Okay, and that's the way she ends. We'll be back in just a moment to present our winners with some prizes. We're going to get our bowlers out here now to pick up their winning prizes. First of all, Ellie Vogt, third place finisher. Congratulations, Ellie.
Pleasure to be here.
Thank you for being here and nice bowling. See you again. Second place finisher, Joan Brochu. Joan, real nice bowling. Congratulations to you. And we'll see you again.
I hope.
Thanks enough. Thanks again. Okay, and $300 to our first place finisher, Phyllis Saroy. Thank you.
Thank you.
Phyllis, nice bowling.
Thank
excellent
you
bowling
much.
Today.
We'll see you next
what are you going to do with all that money, my dear?
Oh, I don't know yet. Probably put it in the bank.
All right.
I've probably been in the bowling alley, I'm sure.
All right. Thank you again, Phyllis. Ladies and gentlemen, join us again next week when we'll present another Pepsi Duck Pin Challenge. Bye-bye for now.